kicker in a julep or two. The thrill of the thought that you might give a thought to my plea casts a spell over me. Still I say to myself, get a hold of yourself. Can't you see it never can be? You go to my head with a smile that makes my temperature rise like a summer with a thousand Julys. You intoxicate my soul with your eyes, though I'm certain that this heart of mine hasn't a ghost of a chance in this crazy romance. You go to my head, you go to
nice seeing you, Johnny. Where have you been?
I've been around. Don't you know me?
I thought you were dead, Joe.
No.
Bad.
Excuse me. You haven't changed much. I never meant to hurt you.
Who said you hurt me? I owe the best years of my life to you, Joe. The years after you left me. The years after Velma Dean came along. She put a leash and a collar around your neck and taught you to sit up and beg.
Okay, that's enough. I don't blame you for being sore.
Who's sore? Maybe at first, sure. But now I go to sleep nights without crying. No, I'm not sorry to Joe. As a matter of fact, I feel very sorry for you. You haven't got anything left to live for except your own funeral. You know that, don't you? And who's going to mourn for you? Velma Dean?
What about Velma Dean?
Well, you and Velma. It's a right thing. Remember, you told me that. Hurry to her, Joe, dear. She'll welcome you with open arms. Me, I've got another show to do. So long, Joe.